actually up on land. He's pretty hesitant to come forward, so Dugan can literally walk back as fast as he's coming forward. Give it up for him, he's done an awesome job. But you can see the difference in his behaviour from when I'm up here compared to when I'm actually getting down close to his water. So I'm pretty confident that we're so safe up here on land. Zach, can you come here for a second? Can you just sit down? Yeah, go sit down right there. I'm going to get that here. Maybe lighting?
Not too long.
And you didn't even move. Now, Zach couldn't have been much more compromised just then. And Scratchy barely made any effort whatsoever to come and get him. But when we start mucking around near his water, that's when he starts to... Give me a nod, I mean. Do you reckon, Scrapper? Yeah, he can't help himself. It's pretty warm and nice up there on the bank. But as soon as he sees me walk around in his water, mucking around, it's when he really just can't help himself. Because this is his territory. And he's watching me mucking around saying, mate, that's my home. Not only is it where he gets quite to eat, but it's where he lives. It's his whole life. So what this kind of tells me is that crocodiles are about the easiest predator that you could possibly live alongside. I mean, what do you reckon, Zach? We're right up here with him. He's not really making too much of an effort.
So what we are trying to show you today is that you can live alongside crocodiles. Don't do what we've done today. Don't go near the water's edge, say 3 to 5 meters back, you'll be able to even the largest strike zone of their largest crocodile ever recorded. Don't overhang the water like I showed you over there, catch 4 meters into the tail of the croc. Third and final rule, and it's the easiest rule to avoid, is don't go into the water. If you don't go into the home of the crocodile, you won't fall victim to the crocodile. By keeping yourself safe and following these rules, not only keep yourself safe, your family safe, your friends safe, but you actually keep your crocodile safe. Because unfortunately when someone is taken by a crocodile, that is then gone out and they hunt the crocodiles. They try and find that one, but ultimately they take two or three. And it's what we're against here at Zoo, because if you can just stay safe up in Northern Australia, keep yourself safe, you'll keep your crocodile safe.
Absolutely.